On my path to a more fit me, I began an exercise regimen. But part of that program includes a post-workout supplement. I asked a dietitian if it was worth the $35 price tag.
It looks very good, actually. It looks like it's based on the complex carbohydrates refueling after you work out, because while you're working out, you're burning your liver glycogen, your blood glucose, and you're burning your muscle glycogen, and you have to replenish that after you work out.
Once I got it, I didn't have it when I first started the workout. I started drinking it a week or so into it, and I noticed my muscles weren't as sore the next day. So maybe there's something to it.
So how would you feel about letting a dietitian look in your fridge and critique the food in there? I was a little nervous about what she'd find.
It's sort of clean. All right.
The whole milk. That's a big one. And it does make a difference, which is what I would recommend going, trying to get down to that, 1%.
Now, if you notice, there's a lack of low-fat stuff in my regime. I've got mayonnaise. Any brand is fine. I also have real butter.
But there are some butters out there in the grocery store that are made with a canola oil or healthier oils, so they're not as high in saturated fat, and you get the heart healthy benefit from those. And the real bacon, if you like it better, it's going to be okay in moderation. I'm saying like two slices at a time. Something that's even better than the regular bacon is Canadian bacon.
And this might be surprising to those of you who drink a lot of diet sodas.
The most recent research on diet beverages has found that people who drink diet sodas tend to actually gain weight. The fake sugar, I guess you could say, in those sodas causes your body to kind of crave the calories that you're promising but you're not delivering.
Not everything in my refrigerator was unhealthy. I did have some fresh fruits and vegetables, all good stuff. My bread selection was healthy too.
How much fiber's in there?
3 grams.
That's actually good.
The inspection was certainly informative, but the reviews on my food choices were mixed.
I would probably give you about a B minus, I would say. Just because there's definite things that you could work on.
B minus is not bad.
I think she was being a little kind. Yeah, she said maybe C, but I didn't want to give you a C. But what was interesting is it was surprising to see the easy substitutions you can make by cutting down the fat and increasing the healthy benefits of your food.
And you don't have to compromise taste.
Compromising taste, exactly. And she did say some of the no-fat products are actually worse for you because they have a lot of sugar in them. So you might want to, I didn't throw anything out. I'm going to use up what I have and gradually replace it with healthier choices.
Good.
So
the
Canadian bacon thing, I'll try that. I like Canadian bacon.
Yeah.
So might be a good thing to go in your fridge and say, let's see, get rid of that.
And give it to Neal.
Do you cook it? I mean, are you, do you actually use the stuff that's in your fridge?
I actually do, yes.
Okay.
See, the problem is sometimes I don't use it up in time, so I
waste factor.
Well, I try to freeze it before it goes bad.